So this is the problem you're going to work on this weekend. I'm saying that it's an example of social design through spatial design, using a case that's kind of close at home here. So on college campuses like this one, architects and planners often design space in an effort to influence certain patterns of behavior. For example, parking lot designations are intended to discourage first-year students from bringing vehicles to campus. There's a reason for this, right? They're trying to encourage first-year students to spend more time on campus and to encourage ride-sharing with friends and that kind of stuff. But the basic idea is that if you look at the age of from kind of seniors to first year, what you'll notice in the parking lot designations is that if this is distance, seniors tend to be able to park near their dorms, and first-year students tend to park kind of far away from their dorms in terms of where they're allowed to park. Is that fair? And so the idea is that if this is kind of social behavior, there's this effort to kind of discourage, or really to kind of encourage or facilitate, I should guess, would be, and there's some kind of a relationship here. And I'm not, you know, it's not like a pure math function. I don't know if it's really like a linear thing or if there's more of an S to it or what. But the idea is that proximity encourages behavior, and the lack of proximity discourages it, right? Kind of basic. It's the underlying kind of premise behind food deserts, environmental justice, and many other things that we'll see. Is this kind of the mapping of social class to distance is a really recurring theme, regardless of the kind of the surface structure. In this case, we're dealing with a case we're familiar with, but we'll kind of I think see this a few times in the future. So what I'm going to do is, let's see, what we're going to give you are two rasters, a campus parking layer and a first year dormitory layer. And so the basic idea, let's see, is that you're going to get, imagine a situation where you have this guy here. Represents the dormitory, and then you've got this parking lot, see, I'm going to throw two more on here. Little guy down here. And someone over here. Okay, and we're going to say that this is a pretty coarse map, but from here to here is about 1,000 meters. Is that all right? I could write that smaller. Sorry, but that's kind of just trying to stick it all in here. And so the idea is that we want to figure out what parking lots are more than a quarter mile away, where the further the better. So I think the idea here is that we want to get to something that's like a quarter mile away, but the further away, if you're out here, you're going to be even more suitable than if you're in here. Is that all right? So another way of kind of trying to maybe picture this is that if we had this set up where this is distance and we're going from zero, and let's say here is a quarter mile, and we had this as our suitability score, we're going to be no deal where if we have zero represents not suitable, and something high up here, let's just say 30, represents really suitable, that when you get to a quarter mile, we'll give it a certain amount, but as you go kind of further away from a quarter mile, is that fair? So the idea is that less than a quarter mile, it's not suitable, so it's going to get a very low score, where the value here represents how suitable it is. And then once you hit a quarter mile, you get to be somewhat suitable, but it's even better the further you get. Is that fair? Okay, and let me just hide this for a second. And then what we say is that we give you two rasters. So let's imagine that one raster represents campus parking. And so what I'm gonna do here is locations for parking is equal to one, and locations for not parking is equal to zero. So every time a cell hits a parking layer, I'm gonna give it a one. Okay, and I'll even quickly color this in. There it is. So that's this layer, and then you're gonna have another layer that's gonna be the same exact size, right? Same exact extent in the sense of number of rows, number of columns, cell size is the same. But this one is gonna represent a first year dormitory. And in this one, the cells are going to get a 1 if they are under, if they overlap with the dormitory. And then they're going to get a 0 if they do not. And you're probably wondering why the raster above me didn't get zeros. And it's because it's late and I've been doing this all day and I forgot to put them in. Fair enough. So that's ones and zeros. And then this guy. Will look something like that. And so these are our means. This is our goal. Let's come up with a plan now to identify these guys and to score them in a way that's kind of like this. Okay.